Fitness Center, Life Belt Extravaganza. Can you guys hear me out there? Alright, here we go. Today's event is sponsored by Family Taekwondo and Fitness Center, the oldest established school in Brevard County. We're located on the corner of Nassau Boulevard and Babcock Street in Melbourne. Our student body consists of students from ages 4 to 65. Over one-third of the students are women. Family Taekwondo develops our physical abilities, but also teaches leadership skills and self-confidence. Family Taekwondo offers classes to the beginning and advanced students, as well as having an excellent children's program. We just recently started up the Ninja program, which starts for children age 4. Family Taekwondo Center is a reliable, fun way to help students become a better person, both physically and mentally. We welcome and encourage everyone to stop in and observe our classes. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand as we sing a salute, our national anthem, Mr. Len Fallon.
retired Taekwondo for over 21 years. He is a recognized international referee in martial arts, and he has earned his internationally accredited fifth degree black belt. Fortunately for his students, over 14 years ago, he established the Family Taekwondo and Fitness Center and brought with him his vast experience in Taekwondo to Brevard County. Family Taekwondo and Fitness Center is recognized as one of the finest martial arts schools in Central Florida today. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Master Instructor.
Okay, right now we're going to get started with introducing the black belt candidates for the testing. This afternoon you will witness the exciting completion of the black belt testing. In order to earn a black belt in Taekwondo, a student must train for years, successfully complete dozens of challenging tests. Students will spend hundreds of hours developing their fighting skills, self-defense techniques, perfecting forms, and complex fighting combinations. So now let's go ahead and introduce the red belt candidates for testing today. First, Chris Chern.
Please have your applause for the influence. Next, Danny Gonzalez.
Next up is Brian Evander.
Robbie McCarthy.
Lori Warren.
Have been training for many years to reach this level in the martial arts. In addition to the physical training, they are also required to spend at least 100 hours instructing Taekwondo. They have worked long and hard and have earned the right to wear the black belt. Sometimes people, though, make a mistake in thinking that once we've reached our black belt, we're through. This isn't true, because as we set these goals, we must then set higher goals and strive to reach those. This level is just the beginning. Now, I would like to announce the candidates for the second degree black belt. Christian Burst.
George Cunningham.
In Taekwondo, setting goals is an important part of the art we practice. In reaching those goals, we then set higher and even more difficult goals. This black belt candidate has set that higher goal, now testing for his third degree. Jose Figueroa.
Being an accomplished student of martial arts can be a long and difficult journey, but certainly one that is worthwhile. The men you are about to meet have been on this road to excellence a long time. They have worked hard and honed their skills and are perfecting the art of Taekwondo. Many have made this journey, but few have gone this far. Now testing for the distinction of their fourth degree black belt, Mr. Lynn Fallon.
Yeah! Mike Cartman! Mr. Willie Ruffin. He's been training for nearly 15 years to get to this level. Give them a hand, please.
Now, Mr. McCarthy is going to introduce some guests that have come in to participate in the extravaganza.
Some of the people I've been involved with for many years in martial arts are here tonight as a tribute to our black belts and just to be a time we can all be together again and gather and have a nice camaraderie, keep our friendship. This first guest I'm going to bring out has been with me for well over 20 years now. We've been good friends. We've traveled all over the world together. And I want to present Mr. Mason Jackson. This is a special recognition award presented with honor and with deep appreciation of Master Jackson for all of his time and effort and work in martial arts, my friend as well. Okay, my second guest, Master John Valera, good friend for many years ago. To spend a lot of time together for a lot of years. Again, we traveled all over Europe together and through the islands and the Caribbean. He's been in Louisiana for many years and training and working out there, practicing law. And he's now recently come to Miami and has a school there. And I also want to introduce his beautiful wife, Elizabeth. Come on, please. Works at the school and teaches, spends a lot of time and dedication. Thank you guys very much.
We just have a small plaque and appreciation to Master McCarthy. He has been a real inspiration for all martial artists, all of Florida and Louisiana, and been a real beacon for us and always helped us out. So we really appreciate it. It says in honor of your outstanding contribution to martial arts excellence. And everyone give him a big hand, please.
My next guest is a friend for a few years now. We met about 3 years ago, traveling and at some different martial art conventions and extravaganzas, and we formed a very close bond over these years. Mr. Chip Lukes. Good man. He's got a nice school, a very successful school in West Palm Beach. And I've been down there many times helping him with events and testings and things. I appreciate you coming up here today. Thank you again. This next guest has been a friend for probably close to 20 years as well. We went to the same university together in San Diego, California, and we didn't know each other at the time. We both trained under the same master. He was with my teacher's brother, and I was with Master David Chenin. We met each other in Florida, coincidentally, on a fluke one day. But I'd like to present him today and have him come out. Mr. Cliff Pappas, please. Our next guest is a professor at a college down in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, or Davie, Florida, actually. He's been a friend again for about 20 years. We've come up in Taekwondo together. We've had a lot of opportunities to travel and compete and do things. And Mr. Vince Garasso. My next guest has a school in Lauderhill, Florida. And she's been a beacon to all the women in martial arts. Very powerful lady, strong. She happens to be married to a friend of mine, Master Jeff Krupp, who I've known for about 22, 23 years involved in this art. And she's here today representing her school. I'd like to give her a warm thank you and a nice token of our appreciation. Ms. Krupp, please. Ms. Krupp. This next guest is Don Ahn. I've watched him from a young boy grow up to a very strong man, one of the best black belts in martial arts I know. He has a very successful school in Orlando, Florida right now. And he started with me when he was about 10 years old. And he's still with me. I'm proud to have Mr. Mike Hartman, please. Thank you very much, Mike. We're going to see a lot more of him in a few minutes during his black belt testing for his fourth degree black belt today.
If I can carry on to that story, I walked in his door as a young boy and respected him then. I stand here as a man today and today I respect him even more. And sometimes I don't give the chance to say it, but sincere, you know, appreciate you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Also, a friend is here tonight. He is also testing for his fourth degree black belt. We'll have a lot of opportunities to see him perform. He's an excellent martial artist. He's been a good friend for a lot of years as well. And also, he's been my student and a student of Master Mason Jackson. As a matter of fact, he's when he started out in this art. He's been a friend and traveling and things with me for a lot of years, Mr. Willie Ruffin. Thank you very much. While I'm in a moat here giving out awards and things, I'm going to take this opportunity to say thank you to some of the staff. We've got a terrific staff from Family Taekwondo Center that helps with all the ninja programs, the children's programs, the SWAT team program, also with the adult classes. Today was a lot of effort. This isn't just put together in one day, this show. We've been preparing this for the last month or two. And I have a few students who spent a lot of time with me and really did a lot of work and dedication. And they were up till 3 hours last night getting the programs typed up and everything in order. And I'd like to start off with thanking Mrs. Petrina Bixfield. She brought me the plaque. I'm going to give it back to her. Ms. Petrina, please. Thank you very much for all your time and your effort. Good job. Also, Mr. Lynn Fowd, the program director at the school, he's testing for his fourth degree black belt today. Mr. Lynn. Appreciate you for all your work and effort. I have Miss Kathy Frio, please. She was up all night last night. This is an award to show you some of our appreciation for all the effort you put in the school and all the years you've been with me. Thank you. Okay, one of our fine announcers, Mr. Brian Lipton. And also, Mr. Jim Finch, who happened also did the posters. Have any of you seen posters around town? He's a fine artist. He has a business that he does as a profession, and he did a great job. Mr. Jim Finch. The head of our SWAT team, you're going to see our SWAT team, which is a special winning attitude team. It's a group of kids who put a lot of effort into their performances and their work. They dedicate themselves. And to be dedicated takes a very dedicated teacher with a lot of patience. And our head of our SWAT team, Mr. Clay Morgan. Thank you for all your work. I'd like to have a plaque to give every single student and black belt I have at this school, I'll be honest with you, because everyone works hard and we do a lot of dedication. And I appreciate all of you guys. Great job.
Now let the testing begin. We're going to have forms demonstrations, please. The first form will be form 4, Wanyo Young. This is one of the earlier forms. It's the green belt form. We're watching a series of strikes, blocks, kicks, and punches. We practice these routinely. Good job.
Today you're going to see samples of 15 different forms. Today they're only going to do 6. Some of the higher black belts have to know, today they have to know up to 15 forms. Each one is choreographed differently. Some have a lot of hand techniques, others have a lot of kicking, and some have a combination of both.
This is form 2 yards, number 9. This is the black belt form. The higher belt, and this is the first one they learn before they become a black belt.
This is form number 10, Wange Young. This is actually the first black belt form.
Back is form number 12. It's form for the second degree black belt. Later on in the demonstrations, you'll be watching some power breaks. These kicks that they demonstrate here, they can go through 3-4 boards. Some of the punches are very, very powerful. Elbow strikes, back fist, blocks, another back fist. Jumping roundhouse kick, very difficult combinations.
This is form number 14, Junjiang Yang. This form is the first form that they learn after you become a second degree black belt. You notice there's some on the ground techniques too.
We're about to witness our one-step sparring demonstrations. These are attack and defense scenarios which we practice continually in order to hone our skills. These are simple attacks coming forward. and anywhere from simple to complex defense techniques. White belt, the first technique.
Second white belt. One, two, three.
Stepping out and striking to the ribs.
First yellow belt technique. One, two.
Yellow belt's more complex. Ending with an axe kick.
Second yellow belt. One, two.
Again, block, chop, head, and kick.
One, two, three.
Green belt technique.
Green belt number two. One, two.
Each belt level has two different techniques and the combinations.
Blue belt number one.
Blue belt number one.
Two.
Back fist. Very difficult kick. Blue belt number two.
One.
Series of punishing kicks. Blocks. The first one. Followed by two more that finish the opponent.
Round belt number one. One. Two.
Block. And kick to the body.
Round belt number two. One.
We have a series of kicks that block as well as defend. Red belts can start with the sweeps and the takedowns.
Red belt number two. One.
Again, you'll see a takedown technique. Don't want that to be your head when you're down there.
Red belt three down.
Good job.
Each belt rank had two self-defense techniques. Black belts have 10 alone.
Black belt number two. One, two.
That was the second black degree. Second black belt. One step. Now we change attack positions. We have regular punch, but we're starting in a fighting stance.
Number four. One, two.
The higher up you get, you get more involved in throws. Some board breaking techniques to show that the red belts do have the technique and the power to defend themselves. What they're doing now is they're going to set up and do three separate breaks. One is going to be a front leg side kick, another one is a reverse punch, and the third is an axe kick.
Side kick.
Some of the techniques you'll be seeing are very, very difficult. It's too bad Christian doesn't have a little bit more flexibility, but I'm sure he'll be able to pull it off anyway.
Pass out!
George Cunningham is now going to be breaking through two boards. Spinning back kick. Very nice. Rich hand strike. Parents, make sure your kids are not doing this to the furniture when you get home. Next break will be four boards. Jose is testing once again for his third-degree black belt. Jose is very agile. He's had quite a bit of gymnastics training. Sets up. Watch the height that he gets on this. Four boards. Very nice. Extremely comfortable. Bruce Farrell, please come to the backstage. Bruce Farrell, to the backstage, please. Mr. Lennon is going to be testing for his fourth-degree black belt. He's now setting up. He will have, I believe, four different strike zones. This is a technique you would use in the event of a multiple attack situation. Working the opponents with a series of elbow strike, chop, axe kick, and I believe a reverse punch. Axe kick, very nice. Now I'm going to demonstrate a power break technique. Four boards. Very difficult. Finish. Very nice. Very difficult. Is now going to be demonstrating the power technique. One board, we got there in the audience.
This is going to be a demonstration. Chung Mu A&B is what it's called. What we have is form number 9, Chung Mu Young, is done with two people, his partners. One will perform one half of the form and the other one will perform the other half as an attacker. This shows how Chung Mu can be used for defending and returning attacks.
2 minutes.
Chung Mu Young!
At any given time, one or the other person could be doing part of the form while the other person is attacking. So you virtually have to know two kinds of forms. Good job. Very good job. Danny and Brian both are participants in our SWAT team. And right now they're going to show you a very short demonstration of working with the ball staff. Both of these boys have choreographed this by themselves. Yeah. Now, Jose Figueroa and Robbie McCarthy are going to do their own demonstration. They're going to do a form of one steps, one kicks, and some breaks. This game is choreographed by these two folks.
Janine and Chris are brother and sister. They're coming out now to do a demonstration of their bow form.
Is going to show a demonstration of board breaking. She's going to show you what kind of strength she has. You'll see what kind of agility we have. That's a very difficult kick. A lot of people have trouble with that kick doing it on the ground. Don can do it in midair. Jim is going to show you a little bit of power technique. Jim is going to go through two boards with a yoke sudo, knife hand.
One more board.
This technique is a lot easier with a foot than it is with a hand. It's very difficult to go through four pieces of wood. Very good, Jim. Good job. Steve Freela is going to come in and show you another difficult kick. Steve is a third degree black belt. He's been with the school longer than me, about 12 years, 14 years. This is a one-holder person. He's going to stand and do an ass kick over his head. It's very difficult to get the strength up at the top of the arc. Mike Izzo's going to do it. Mike is a first-degree black belt with the family taekwondo. He's going to show a series of panitoichagis, reverse spinning kicks. Speed and strength combined. Very good job. Up next, we've got a demonstration with a SWAT team. This is a super winning attitude team. Thank you. Taekwondo Family SWAT Team. Bailey Fallon, Ryan Sides, James Wright, Brian Evander, Andrew Van Orden, Danny Gonzalez, headed up by Clay Morgan. Give him a round of applause. Good job. Coming up next, we're going to have our guest demonstrations. First is Reggie Butler. Reggie Butler started out at Family Taekwondo Center 12, 13 years ago. He since then got his black belt with us and he moved out of state. Right now he's residing in New Jersey. He's an instructor at a school in New Jersey and he's planning on moving again to Maryland. Reggie's going to go through a series of self-defense techniques and then he's going to do a flying sidekick break.
This is our wholesale store self-defense techniques. These are very practical applications in some very bad situations. Good job. She's with the Ware Eagle Soar Taekwondo School, located in Coral Springs, Florida. It was established in 1989. Master Koop has over 20 years of teaching experience. He has trained with Master McCarthy and traveled throughout the world with him, representing the United States in various competitions. Mrs. Koop has been a black belt teaching children and adults for the past 11 years, and she'll be going on for her fourth degree in January. Representing the school today, along with Mrs. Koop, are Mr. Cordles, Mr. Summers, and Mr. DeMinto. Very powerful kick. Tommy Toyachagi, step through. Nice. Smash. Two boys. Nice technique. Power portion for demonstration looks like it's going to be through four boards. A lot of women don't think they have the power or the strength to participate in Taekwondo. You can see they're greatly mistaken. Very tough break. All the way through. One more, one more. Let's concentrate. Good try. Nice try. Sometimes we win, sometimes the boards win. Nice job. Give him a big hand.
Coming up next is Greg Chalk from Family Taekwondo Center. So far, all the breaks that you've seen so far have been held with two hands, one on top, one on bottom. Greg is going to do a yokesudo, which is the inside ridge hand, holding just the bottom portion of the boards. There's no resistance at the top. You've got to have a great speed and strength to go through the boards. Coming up next, Mr. Willie Ruffin and Cliff Pappas are going to show a demonstration for us. He's got two schools down there, one in North Miami Beach and one in Fort Lauderdale. He started teaching Taekwondo in 1985 and has been training in Taekwondo since 1981. Mr. Cliff Pappas has been in Taekwondo for 15 years. He's a second degree black belt. He got his black belt under Master Kwan, and he's been training also with Master David Chenin. Currently, he lives in New Hampshire. Instructor is throwing one kick at a time, showing the speed and agility and strength. Mr. Pops is going to demonstrate how he's going to do his break and how it will be effective. The first one's called a twisting kick, or pichochagi. This kick is very difficult. Normally you're used to going around forward, this one's going outside. The second break is going to be a ridge hand. And he's going to do a double flying side kick, two boards at once. This next kick is very difficult to do.
Vince Gross and Mason Jackson will now be coming up for their demonstration. He's the retired chief instructor of the Fort Lauderdale. He trained with Master McCarthy under Grandmaster Kwan for 14 years. He is an international competitor from Germany, Italy, Greece from 1979 to 1986. Vince Caruso is a third-degree black belt. He's a Taekwondo instructor at Broward Community College. He trained with Master Kwan since 1976. Ho Dang Young is Form 17. They will be doing that together. Form 17 is a very difficult and obviously very high form for the black belts. Very few of us know those forms, and I'm one of them that doesn't know them. Power and breakthrough four boards, very, very difficult. Russell, please be quiet out there. Several boards broke under the top one. Nice job. Difficult break. He's got a hit with both feet almost simultaneously while he's in the air. Ooh, almost. He's got to focus while he's in the air on two individual targets, kicking them. All the way through. Yes! Station break. Nice break. One more. One leg is kicking two boards with a roundhouse and then coming back with a back hook kick. Ooh, it's tough. He's up there. He's kicking almost 6 feet in the air doing this. If we broke these boards every time, you guys might think it's too easy. That's why you gotta see, it's very, very hard.
Chip Lutz
is next. Mr. Lutz, please. Demonstrating various blocks, punches, and strikes, and his hand techniques. Nice job. Double kick, very difficult there. job. Going to be demonstrating one-step sparring now. Signal must be made so that the attacker can be ready and the defender ready so there's no accidents. Very disciplined, that's why it's a martial art. First key up signals the defender will be ready for the attack, and then the defender executes the appropriate defense. Nice elbow strike. Block, the punch, and then retaliates several strikes to the face. Block, elbow twice to the face, joint block technique, and a kick to the body. Very nice defense technique. Good job, nice job. Showing some various knife defense techniques. One time you use a weapon, you have to practice these continually. They're very, very dangerous. Even the most skilled martial artist can mess up, and it actually can happen. So you practice with these weapons all the time. One of the first means of defense in the family taekwondo school, when anybody comes at you, you turn and you leave the area. It's the most safe. Nice job. Now I'm going to demonstrate a form. Good job, nice. Now demonstrating both techniques. This is a bow form. We're watching a series of strikes and blocks and defense techniques with the bow. Very effective weapon. Nice job. Good job, guys. Now, this will be Olympic-style point sparring, we'll see. In point scoring, you score points to the head, reverse punches to the bodies, and body shots. You must make contact with trembling force, and that's force good enough to stop an opponent dead in his tracks. When we spar, it's usually very light contact, because we want to be around to spar again the next time. We're wearing your chest protectors now, and the headgear. Normally when we suit up, we'll also have foot gear and hand guards, as well as possibly a cup and a mouthpiece, and shin guards and arm guards. Come here. Respect the bout of the audience. Nice. Chest protectors, you still get a hit, but at least you don't break a rib. Help! shots would be to your points. Nice shots, one nice. Very good job. Good control. Good control. Michael, will you doing a power break? Watch the technique. He has to concentrate. Boards don't break easily, and you've got to focus right on the center of them in order to break them. Step through. Nice shot. Another breaking combination. Jump front kick. Turn jump. Right through it. Nice. Flying side kick now will be demonstrated.
Ooh. Ah, oh.
Here they go.
Oh.
Nice. Stepping back side kick will now be demonstrated.
And a back
spinning kick. Head level. With a single holder, it's got to hit it fast and hard. One is a two-board break, one is a higher break to the head. One board, real fast. Nice. Coming out, three different positions. Here it comes. Setting up now for a multiple attacker scenario. Get the height. Probably a foot over his own head.
Power! Power!
Oh, he's got it.
Guest up is Master John Valero. Master Valero has his own school called Dynamic Taekwondo Academy. Master John Valero has 20 years experience in Taekwondo. The last 8 years with Grandmaster Moon in New Orleans. He's just opened a new school in Ventura, Florida. Master Valero is a Louisiana full contact state champion, semi-finalist for the 1988 Olympic trials for Taekwondo, 3-time won the top fighter in World Games in Munich, Germany. Thank you.
He's going to show you how he's going to do it first. That was two kicks, one spin. John Valero and his students. Next up, Family Taekwondo black belts are going to do a form called Bo'an Young.
Black belt candidates are now demonstrating red belt bow form. Here again, you're watching a series of strikes, blocks, attacks, and defense. A sweep involved. A strike to the body, back to the head, and finish. Now we're going to see the black belt bow form. More involved, more strikes, more attacks, more spins, giant sweeps, and just more difficult general. Must maintain control of the bow at all times. The spins enable you to get speed for the attacks. Also confusing your opponent. Many hours of training to get to that level of excellence. Nice job. Red belts will now be demonstrating their self-defense techniques. Okay. First one is the headlock release.
Top
of the scenario, somebody coming up, attacking someone, maybe to grab them by the head. And the appropriate response. Heart attack, attack to the chest.
Finish. Sum up hair grab. Big one.
Sum up hair grab, the appropriate response. Finishing punch, and then a finish with a break of the arm.
One.
See the takedown, and then the break. Good job.
Cole Nelson, groin attack. Turn.
Another attack that may be typical is a full Nelson. Don't think they'd want to do that again.
Turn.
Steps behind, picks the leg up, attacks the groin.
You have a lapel grab.
Someone might want to rough you up a little bit, grab your lapel, try to intimidate you. Just broke their arm. They won't do that again either. Sleeper technique is something you'll see applied often. They step back, throw the hand down, finish with an elbow strike.
And turn.
Depending on how much you like your opponent, you can throw them to whatever height you want. We're dropping them down low. Nice job, guys.
Next up, we're going to have some black belt candidates do some sparring for us. First off is Christian and Jar. Again, Jose Figueroa is testing for his third degree, Mike Carpenter for his fourth degree. I don't see too many low kicks. The speed is phenomenal. First up is Brian Evander.
To become a black belt for the children takes almost 5 years, sometimes a little more. Brian is just excellent in all his techniques. He trained so hard, he's been a member of the SWAT team since its conception. Brian's been training for, I think, nearly 6 years, and he just does outstanding. Also is an outstanding in his schoolwork, very bright young man, very talented in martial arts. Nice job, Brian. Danny Gonzalez. Danny's also been training for close to 6 years. He trains very, very hard. He's been a member of the SWAT team for years too. He also does extremely well in his academic studies. Always has the right attitude, a good smile, and ready to try anything. Nice job, Danny. Good job. Next up, Chris Churin. Chris, you watched do some very nice bow work with his sister. They've been training at Taekwondo now for years. Chris has got very good capabilities with his martial arts training. These kids you're seeing right now are the junior black belts. That's what denotes the red and the black stripes. But they have done just about everything they need to do to reach the black belt level. The only thing that's holding them back from being a black belt right now is their age. Nice job, Chris.
Next up is Gary Warren.
Again, the adults have to work with students for a few hours, about 100 hours, teaching. Lori helps me out with the ninja class. She's an excellent instructor, and she does very well with children. She's always got a positive attitude in class, and is willing always to help out anybody at any time. And that's part of being a black belt. Once you achieve your black belt, now you have to spread it on to other students. Next up is Jim Nicholas. Jim has been training with Family Taekwondo Center again for several years, 5 years. Him and Laura both did a bow demonstration earlier. They came up with that bow form themselves. They worked on it for weeks to get it perfected, and they did a nice job on it. Ron has excelled tremendously with his self-defense. He does an excellent job. He's also a very good instructor, deals well with the kids.
He also saw Tom demonstrate the bow for him. He's got quite a command with the bow. Very powerful techniques he demonstrated. He's been training for years. His flexibility has vastly improved and increased. His concentration and his dedication to the art is commendable. Good job. Next we have another special candidate. It's Robbie McCarthy. He's been training now for close to 15 years. He's actually 10 years. He started just when he was about 6, and he's been working very, very hard. I remember when he would come in and he was much smaller than me. Now I'm afraid that the roles are going to be reversed. He's special because Master McCarthy is his father. And he's been training his son all these years. And today, the special relationship a student-instructor has is being transcended a little bit by having it be his father. The significance of an instructor-student relationship is very important. We have a great deal of respect for Mr. McCarthy. He's very, very proud of his son. And today, he would like to give him his black belt. A lot of these people were here last year training for the first part. They're back. They've done an excellent job, and I just got to commit it myself.
The first degree black belts. Congratulations. Coming up next is those are the for second degree. Christian Burke. As you can see, Chris has a black belt on, so he doesn't get a new black belt. He gets a certificate, and he's promoted to second degree black belt.
George Cunningham.
George is from a school over in Orlando. Mike Hartman is his instructor. He's been promoted to second degree black belt also. Jose Figueroa. Jose's been with Master McCarthy 13 years. He's promoted to third degree black belt. Been with Master McCarthy since the school's been open. He was one of the first students. He's also the chief instructor of the school. He runs out of the administrative parts of the school. Promoted to fourth degree black belt. Next up, Willie Ruffin. Willie Ruffin again is from Fort Lauderdale and Miami Beach. Mike Hartman. Mike Hartman has a school over in Orlando. He has been promoted to fourth degree black belt. All the students are now going to take the black degree oath.
Gentlemen, please raise your right hand, ladies. Repeat after me. After I say hi, please repeat your own name. I accept with honor and privilege the black belt in Taekwondo. And you hereby swear to uphold the standards of courtesy, integrity, perseverance, self-control, and indomitable spirit. And to maintain a high moral code. I sincerely pledge to honor my instructor in school. With loyalty and support. And to carry on the family Taekwondo Center tradition. With respect and dignity. I further pledge. With humility and gratitude. Physical and spiritual growth to the highest level. To lead by example and to share what I've learned with others. Ladies and gentlemen, you're now officially black belts to next level.
His school demonstration, and then after that we have the Night of the Ninjas. Thank you.
Thank you. We'd like to thank you all, ladies and gentlemen, for being with us here. Family Taekwondo Center has come to the close of its black belt extravaganza with all the shows and the demonstrations and the ceremonies and the promotions today. And you all have been a tremendous audience, and we're very glad to have you with us. Thank you so much. We'll see you at the school, 835 South Babcock. Come by and see us anytime. Thank you all for coming, and good night.